Hello, welcome to Expert Village. My name is Wayne Petersen, and I'm the director of the Important Bird Areas Program for the Massachusetts Audubon Society. Today, we're here at the Daniel Webster Wildlife Sanctuary in Marshfield, Massachusetts, where we'll be talking about bird identification and some of the equipment and essential tools that are useful to get one started in this incredibly interesting pastime. One of the things that's very important as we begin to think about identifying birds in the field is to sort of understand what we need to look for. Now, we've mentioned briefly the topographical features of the bird, but there are other things in addition to the physical appearance of the bird. For example, habitat. We're in a meadow here at Daniel Webster Wildlife Sanctuary, where we have a pond behind me and fields and meadows in this direction, so that obviously there are certain birds that we can reasonably expect in these kinds of habitats. At the same time, we can use behavior. For example, the way a bird flies. Woodpeckers and goldfinches typically have a very strongly undulating flight as they travel. Other birds, like the eastern kingbird, typically fly on the tips of their wings and have a very peculiar flickering flight. Swallows, like these purple martins off to my left here, skim and swoop. So these would be all behavioral features that could be very useful in helping you identify an unfamiliar bird. So in general, when we first see a bird, we want to try to put it into some sort of a category. And this, of course, can be based on the way birds are classified. And in fact, in most of the popular field guides today, birds are actually grouped and organized based on their scientific classification. So that if we start with the water birds, which typically occur first in the taxonomic hierarchy that's typical of most field guides, we obviously are looking at fairly large birds, many of which indeed are associated with wetlands, as opposed to many of the forest and woodland birds that would be much smaller and would obviously be more subtle in terms of some of their identification characteristics. So as we move forward through some of these different groups of birds, we'll be using different characteristics and different features as we begin to put them into categories that can be useful for field identification.